Support for the Hub is brought to you by Manscaped, who is the best in men's below-the-waist grooming. Manscaped offers precision-engineered tools for your family jewels. They obsess over the technological developments to provide you the best tools for your grooming experience. Manscaped is trusted by over 2 million men worldwide, and I got an exclusive offer for you guys. 20% off plus free shipping with the code HUB, H-U-B. That's 20% off and free shipping with the code HUB, H-U-B at manscaped.com. Taken in the 2017 draft with the 25th overall pick by the Cleveland Browns, Jabril Peppers isn't somebody you'd consider to be a New York Giants homegrown talent, but he's as close to homegrown as it comes. The strong safety who's been here since the 2019 season via the Odell Beckham trade has been one of the more vocal leaders and fan favorite Giants on and off the field. Now we just need to keep him on the team. So let's take a rewind back to the 2019 offseason, early 2019. COVID didn't exist yet, people were still outside, and the Giants were officially in heavy rebuild mode after they realized Eli might not be the guy to be their quarterback in the midst of the 2018 season. Dave Gettleman just told us that we did not just extend Odell the previous offseason to trade him, and we did exactly that. The Giants traded Odell Beckham to the Browns. In return, they got right guard Kevin Zeitler, their 17th overall pick, a 2019 95th overall pick, and the topic of this video, safe
Jabril Peppers!
The Jabril Peppers. Now, listen. Jabril Peppers, from the moment he was included in the package, people realized was going to be the direct replacement for one strong safety, Landon Collins, who the Giants allowed to walk in free agency. Now, of course, at the time, Gettleman was not the most popular person in New York because he let Collins walk instead of trying to franchise tag him, maybe try a tag and trade scenario, or even trading him during the regular season. Collins ended up going to franchise rival Washington football team, then at the time the Washington Redskins, for what was a massive safety contract that a lot of people considered to be an overpay for, you know, a safety who's had his best years behind him. And while that was an incredible year, by the way, in 2016, where he made a legitimate case to be the defensive player of the entire NFL, his play definitely did not match that since. Getting back to Peppers, however, a lot of Giants fans realized that what they were getting in the Michigan product was a guy that was essentially a younger Landon Collins and maybe a more consistent version of Landon Collins, and that's what they've got so far through his two-year tenure with the Giants. Peppers has been a really good to maybe even great strong safety for the Giants. A lot of people consider his 2020 year just this past season to be on a Pro Bowl caliber level, and that he was most likely snubbed from a Pro Bowl, as they do, to be fair, quite a lot of Giants defensive players because of the performance of the defense overall in 2020, finishing out as a top 10 ranked 9th overall in the NFL. For example, while James Bradbury, their, you know, number one corner, may have gotten his Pro Bowl nod, he definitely did not get his well-deserved All-Pro nod. So it is definitely, you know, reasonably keep in mind, maybe Peppers did truly deserve a Pro Bowl and he just did not get it. But the stats, as they are shown here on the screen, he has been somebody really good for the Giants, improving in his second year from 76 total to 91 total tackles. He maintained his one interception, even got a fumble recovery for us. He was used all over the field. He could get to the quarterback. He's a great tackler, which is once again what the Giants got him for. And Peppers in general has been what we asked him to be and more on the field. He's been a great player for the Giants, and he fits extremely well in this Patrick Graham defense. Now, that's just on the field. Off the field, however, he's been even better. The Giants just recently went on a very nice spending spree, getting a lot of players on their team to help improve that roster even more and maybe try and make a playoff run. Peppers was basically involved in almost every single signing with recruiting these players. He is somebody that loves to be here. And trust me, the fans love him as well. But now this is where the conundrum begins. Before the 2020 season, the Giants went ahead and took safety Xavier McKinney out of Alabama, somebody that was regarded as one of the best, if not the best, safeties coming out in the 2020 draft class, and definitely someone that shouldn't have been there in the second round when the Giants took him, so it makes sense that they would not pass up on such a talent. But when you look at Xavier McKinney's skill set, you say to yourself, You know what? He's somebody that's very similar to Peppers. He's definitely better in some aspects where Peppers lacks, for example, coverage, and he's definitely a little bit more agile, so maybe they do put him out at free safety, but it got you wondering. But we never got a chance to see what would happen with Xavier McKinney because he was then injured right before the season began and the Giants were out of their free safety. That's when they then went and signed former Patriot and Titan Logan Ryan, somebody that was converting from the cornerback spot to safety spot, and was kind of a little bit of an experiment, to be honest, in his first year with the Giants, but one that worked out incredibly well. Logan Ryan is his first year starting as a free safety, did a really good job, respectable, better than respectable, whatever you want to call it, but surprised a lot of people and was, you know, legitimately an option for the future. We then extended him Christmas Day, and all of a sudden the Giants are now in a three safety set, which they did run a couple times during the season and worked out fine. But looking towards the future, we're not sure where you're gonna go with this, because you have Logan Ryan under contract for 3 years, albeit you do have the option to get out after two. You have Jabril Peppers, who just finished his fourth year of his five-year, you know, rookie contract. He's entering the fifth-year option now. He will be coming up on his extension. And then, of course, you have the rookie McKinney, who shows a lot of promise, who without a doubt is probably the only constant here. The one person you should 100% expect to still be on the team a couple years from now. And the question is, do they extend Peppers, or do they sacrifice him in order to keep Logan Ryan, or do they get out of the contract of Logan Ryan in order to sign Jabril Peppers, or do they somehow keep all three of them together and continue to run with three safety sets that they have been running with? And while the Giants have shown in the past, in fact, just this past month, to be able to finagle their way out of weird cap situations and create space out of nowhere through the black magic of Kevin Abrams, you don't want to already be too reliant on backloading and restructuring contracts too much, because we've seen that it eventually catches up to you. We've seen right with our division rival in the Philadelphia Eagles that if you do it too much, it's really going to come back and bite you, and you're going to be stuck in an incredibly bad position money-wise. And that brings us back to the question at hand: which route do the Giants take? Which players do they roll with? And now it's the time for us to head to the comment section, because that's where we need to talk. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to like, comment, subscribe, and share. I'll catch y'all in the next one.